Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the first China game of the day. We've got two today. We've got a best of three between VG Gaming and VG Gamer Reborn. And the winner, of course, will move on to the finals to play against eHome in a best of five. I'm OdiePixel. I'm joined for Lumi for this one. Lumi, how are you doing?
I'm doing great. I'm really excited to see the closing and the end of the Chinese brackets because they are really heating up and we have a couple of amazing teams left.
Yeah, we really do. This is going to be an exciting one, and an exciting one as well because I think if you look at the two teams on paper, you probably would say Reborn are the stronger side. But then when you look back at in the round robin, VG Gaming were able to beat VG Gaming Reborn, and I guess that's because these teams, you know, under the same brand, they probably know each other really, really well, and that's why VG Gaming are able to take games off the side of Reborn. I mean, coming into this already, we're now two picks in either side on the draft. And I mean, what do you think about this? VG Gaming with the first pick Drow Ranger. Is this some Chinese stuff or what?
Well, every time I see a first pick Drow Ranger, I always think it's kind of all in because, you know, you reveal your main strategy so early. But I've seen that work really, really well.
Yeah.
Teams sometimes kind of overdraft to prepare for the Drow Ranger, and VG will hit you from a different angle. I'm glad that you brought up the head-to-head between VGR and VG. That game was really, really close. It went to like 60, 70 minutes.
Oh, was
and
it?
Either team could have won. So
okay.
I'm not sure we could really kind of think about that data point a little bit too much, but these two teams are very close. I do agree with you. I think that VGR is the stronger team on paper.
Yeah.
And Mikasa has been playing really well. So if I have to take a bet on either team, I'm going to go with VGR.
I was going to say, yeah, I think yeah, if you're looking for the safe bet, that would be the side that you'd side with. I mean, so far, opening bans and picks, do you like the opening of a certain team more? I mean, both of them are a little unorthodox. The fact that VGR opening with a Wyvern and a Darkseer, and VG Gaming working with a Drow Ranger and a Tyrant. So, I mean, what's happening here? I get it, the Wyvern very good against any kind of Drow strat?
Yeah, I think the Wyvern is a reaction to the Drow strat.
Yeah.
Drow mostly going to push very hard, and they're going to single focus a target very fast. And that's where Wyvern is really good at. You co-embrace the target that she's focusing on, and if we're, for whatever case, a Drow Ranger, when they're pushing, they clump up a little bit, boom, curse. That's a quick kill, and generally that goes your push.
I mean, already, VG Gamer Reborn, the Wombo combo is real, isn't it? What, Winter's Curse, Vacuum, Echo Storm, Earth Splitter, that's some scary stuff, especially for a lineup with the Drow that's going to maybe look to group up and push. You know, VG Gamer Reborn, they're doing everything to make sure that VG Gaming might even have to go around the Drow strat in a different way.
Yeah, normally Wombo combos are weak against Tidehunter because he could shake off the stun and then kind of counter ravage you, and then suddenly your Wombo combo's gone. But Winter's Curse does not care about that. If you curse a Watermelon, Drow Ranger is going to be happy hunting for that day. Also, this Wombo combo lineup have very, very good base defense when it comes to Splinter Blast, Ancestral Spirit, plus Clap. So you're going to see that VG Gaming is going to have a real tough time pushing in. The draft-wise, so far three picks in, I'm with VGR, but the draft could change very rapidly once we see a couple more picks.
It's interesting that, you know, VG Gaming, not to be put off by the fact that VG Gaming really want to have this great punishment for grouping up and going. They're picking the Witch Doctor. So VG Gaming kind of sticking to their guns, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You pick a Witch Doctor, you are going to be grouping up and pushing. And VG Gaming really want to have a lot of counters to that. So VG Gaming just going balls to the wall with their draft. I mean, how do you kind of sustain that the team fight that VG Gaming Reborn are going to bring if you are VG Gaming? Do you need kind of a tanky cores? What else do you follow up with here?
I think you just get rich in the laning stage
because
that's really the strength for the Drow strat, right? You have a lot more base damage to work with. You know, right now what we're talking about, oh, we got the Wombo combo, we got the base defense, we got the AoE. That's all kind of like, you know, armchair theory kind of thing. It doesn't matter that you have the better draft if you're down 10k before the push actually happens. So this is a very interesting pick here for VGR. The Ursa, we haven't seen them actually play this hero pretty much at all. But I guess the idea of this is just get a hero to blink right on Drow Ranger's face and just go on her. Give her a tough time.
Yeah, absolutely. And another, I mean, the amount of physical damage Ursa can do within a matter of seconds is going to be very nice as well with the Elder Titan aura. I mean, pretty much, I guess you can say that anything would be nice with that aura. But yeah, indeed, Ursa, you know, he's going to be able to jump in on these heroes and take any of them down in a few swipes. Even the Titans is going to have to be a little bit wary of the Elder Titan Ursa potent combination.
Yeah, the Ursa pick is smart because right now Vici hasn't shown any hero that has a hard save. Like, we don't have an Oracle, we don't have a Wisp defensive relocate. So right now, if Ursa jumps on Drow, it's a clean kill.
Yes.
And Vici needs to remedy that situation, needs to address this.
Let's see what they pick up here. So, still looking for that mid laner. And that secondary support.
I think the secondary support has to be something like a Wisp or the Orgo, like I mentioned.
Okay.
You do see the Vichy are bans, right? They took out Dazzle, they took out Venge. These are two kind of hard save heroes. Yeah. And there's not much left. Wyvern is also a hard save with Co-Embrace.
Do they ever run Shadow Demon in China?
Yeah, Shadow Demon could be it. Shadow Demon is quite good against Ursa, actually. Because of the...
Demonic Purge.
Demonic Purge is great.
The amp damage. Yeah.
The poison is actually not bad to kind of harass people down. We'll see. The one downside here with all those hard save heroes I mentioned, the Oracle, the IO, the Shadow Demons, they don't have a hard lockdown.
Yeah.
So you're drafting yourself in a kind of difficult situation here.
Now, talking about lockdown, I guess, you know, one of the classics is Disruptor, who is still there. I mean, is this a Disruptor game or is that...
Storm Spirit.
Now, it was the other day, yesterday, wasn't it? We saw Vici Gaming try out the CTY Storm Spirit, and one game he had a great laning stage at the start because he had a Skyroff with him. Second game, he didn't.
He went like 0-3.
Both games, they lost. It was...
Yeah.
I mean, they must really believe in the CTY Storm. Do you think they're kind of down the wrong path here, or is there definitely hope for Storm Spirit?
Well, Storm's going to have a much better early game laning phase, simply because you're on a Drow team. Second, Storm has a very important job this game that I think it kind of fits the draft. You know, right now you're grouping out as a team, but Storm is really the only person that gets to go onto the backline of VGR. Wyvern, Darkseer, Elder Titan, these are all very easy, squishy target for him to jump in once he has the right item. So, also, Storm, one of his weaknesses is his early game farm, which you already addressed with a precision aura. Also, in the mid game, you're going to push down a lot of towers, so he's going to get to that Bloodstone and Orchid very quickly. Not the worst Storm game, just that CTY Storm always gets me a little bit afraid, because he gets to his 20 charge Bloodstone, and he loses that 20 charge Bloodstone also very quickly, so I don't know.
Yes, yeah, and I don't, yeah.
He's hot and cold. I don't know what kind of CTY showed up today.
I was going to say, it's going to have to be quite something. 10 seconds. Well, Vici Gaming with their final BAM. Reborn. And they are looking for their mid laner. They'll take away the Mikasa DK. And even though Mikasa's been very flexible, recently, kind of the latter part of these qualifiers, he has been playing a couple of games of the DK. And I guess something that they obviously can do quite well in lane against a Storm Spirit. My goodness.
Why do you forget the most obvious Drow Visage combo, right?
I mean, it... Wow. So we have this has got to be a new hero for the qualifiers. We've not seen a single Visage game across all four regions, have we?
I don't think we have. So basically, Vici's game is saying,
wow,
you know what? We don't have a lot of save.
Okay.
We don't have a lot of catch. But we're going to just send a Siege Cannon down your mid lane, and we're going to just go. You deal with it. So this is kind of like a very powerful way to react to a draft. Make VGR react to your draft. Their laning stage is so strong. We're going to see a Mirana, and this is going to be a mid lane Mirana, I suppose?
Mikasa Mirana.
Okay.
Yeah, I'd imagine.
Here's a danger of a Mirana pick. Okay. She does nothing for you for the first 20 minutes.
Yeah, she's got to get that axe.
And that's where Vici Gaming is going to hit you fast and hard. So basically, VGR has the confidence that they're going to hold, and then they're going to win late. And I'm not sure whether that's the correct read here. Because Vici is going to come at you very, very strong and very, very fast.
Oh, this is going to be quite something. The first, as I said, I might be wrong, but I'm pretty sure it's the first time we've seen a Visage, unless something's happened overnight whilst I was sleeping. But yeah, Burning Visage. I mean, that hero combination, that itself, maybe in the Chinese scene and in some of the Chinese tournaments and such online, you know, DPL that Vici Gaming run, I'd imagine. Maybe they've been able to see this, but this is really quite something.
Yeah, and I'm actually surprised that Burning's playing the Visage.
You would have thought, what, HYM more likely?
Yeah, generally HYM plays a little bit more technically challenging heroes.
Yeah, he plays like the Earth Spirit.
The Phoenix, Earth Spirit, that kind of stuff. And Burning's generally playing like Venge or Witch Doctor. So I'm surprised they make that swap. So I guess they're pretty confident prepare for battle. On the player with the first triple kill. I'm going to say Burning. Visage is actually a very strong triple hero. Yeah.
I guess the Soul Assumption nukes.
Or second cooldown, man. It's
You know what? I'm going to jump ship. Yep. Burning. Highest net worth at the end of the game. I think VGR are going to have this, so I've got to go with the Ursa. I think N's going to go crazy.
Okay.
And he's such a good farmer as well. We see games like, obviously, it's going to be a very different style.
So you're going to read the VGR victory here.
I'm going to read the VGR victory here. Okay. First barracks kill. I mean, the push obviously is there with Vici Gaming. Will they be able to get far enough to get our axe? I don't know. The counter push seems really good from VGR. I'm going to have to go up with VGR here.
I'm going to play the devil's advocate. I'm going to say Vici is going to be the one that's really pushing fast and hard.
This could be, you know, it's something different. you know, something that we're, you know, the Drow Visage coming back in the China scene. I mean, this was something that we saw a lot, mainly for kind of CIS sides, wasn't it? I mean, was this always something that in the past has been big in China?
No, not really.
More European thing?
More European, yeah. NA kind of thing. And I just going to say, the end screen cap of this game is not going to be close. It will look like a stomp. Because either VG is going to push down VGR in maybe 20 minutes, or this is going to drag out to a 40-minute game where VGR wins. So here we go. We're going to see that Rune fight. Witch Doctor is pretty good here.
Okay, let's see what goes on. The cask is going to bounce. Arrow flies through, won't connect onto anyone. So VGR find the space to get the rune. Question is, does VG want to try and chase down for a kill? It doesn't look like they're going to have the opportunity to. They're looking at Yang, but Yang, he'll be able to walk it off. So.
Ooh, that's a huge win for VGR. Not only did they get the rune, they also forced ROTK to get Gush at level 1.
Oh, that's always a bad sign.
So you don't have Anchor, you don't have Kraken. He's got the Iron Talon.
He wants to
for
go
jungle
as well. And I mean, again, it's not great in lane, it's not great in the jungle. Level 1 Gush.
You could Gush some creeps, man.
Gush 1 creep, that's it.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Might as well.
Yeah, this is going to put a bit of a slowdown onto ROTK. And yeah, as you said, the fact that, you know, also, you know, and at bottom lane, End got the other bounty runes, so both bounty runes to VGR.
Well, that's a great start here for the Reborn squad. HYM is doing some next level backstabbing here, looking for a courier perhaps? Or maybe just warding down the ancients? Not exactly sure about this rotation.
Yeah, let's see what it's up to. If it is going to be. At the same time, VGR's lineup, they're not really the best ancient clearing team,
yeah.
So I guess it's unlikely that they're going to be really prioritizing stacks themselves. So maybe.
Maybe he's looking for the Darkseer, who is.
Could be, yeah.
Who's jungling right now, just hanging out.
Yeah, that's true. Interesting lane decision here. Yeah, Yang straight to the jungle. And by the looks of it, FY on the Elder Titan, he's heading towards that top lane. So maybe see if he gets some XP in. Yeah, H1 just comes into the mid lane. Gives Mikasa a bit of a whack, but well, Mikasa shoots him in the back right in return. And the mid lane matchup at the moment. Slight edge for CTY, 7 for 2 against the 4 for 0. Do you expect this lane to be a lane where the Storm does quite well?
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Even the 1v1 without the draw, I think it's still Storm favor. With the draw especially, it's going to be very Storm favor. FY, running away here from a Gush. As well as a couple of right clicks, he'll be fine.
Plant the tree, eat its anger. He's going to be okay. I mean, this is something to note as well. So the fact that Burning Visage, I mean, this is a hero that you used to pick, was it? To work off the fact that you're in a trial lane versus trial lane situation. So you get those stacks up and you can use the Soul Assumption to max potential. Burning, he's not going to have any offlaner in his lane. So what does this Visage achieve in the early game?
Pretty much nothing. His goal essentially is going to get to level 6.
Yeah.
You talk about Visage's pick for the tri-v-tri lanes. The second reason he's picked is just to get to level 6 and get the push on with Draw Ranger, which is the predominant reason that we see him pick here. So his goal is to get to level 6. You see him doing a couple of stacks, a couple of pulls, and once the 6 is coming, he is going to just push. He also farms quite quickly for a support hero. Because of how many towers you get, how many kills you get with your Soul Assumption. So he will get things like Medallion of Courage, he'll get an Aghanim Scepter quite early. And then, you know, the Triple Birds, obviously so good with the Draw Ranger.
Do you finish off the Solar Crest before the Axe?
Depends on how you... Yeah, you know, against Ursa, yep. Having the mischance on whoever you're protecting might be a pretty good idea. So we'll see how ahead he feels his team's at, and then whether he could afford getting the Solar Crest.
Bit of a walk around here, FY. It's going to drop the hammer onto HYM. And HYM is going to beat him back off. How's RTK's jungling going? He's killed himself, just getting back to base. Picks up infused raindrops and the boots as well. He's managed to find his way to level 3. So he's in a bit of better shape in the jungling terms. Darkseer, Yang, level 4, now coming into the top lane to get some of that lane XP rather than in the jungle. But FY, he's been walking around a lot and he is still just sitting at the level 1 on this Elder Titan. So he's going to have to try and find a level somewhere here.
Yeah, so right now, even though nothing is really looking like it's happening, I got to say the VG R game plan is really coming to fruition. Because right now, VG should be winning every single lane because of the Draw Ranger aura, and they're not.
Yeah, look at this bottom lane. It's a free farm. That's never a good sign, especially when it's End as well. He's shown us some spectacular performances on these kind of safe lane calls when he gets this start of an opening. And, whoa, mid lane.
Well, there's a lane victory.
Okay. Yeah, CTY finding a kill. I was going to look towards top because Yang did get chased down by the three of them, but unable
was
to get the kill.
Just a straight-up solo kill? He didn't have level 6 either, so I guess, you know, Mikasa maybe...
He was hanging around on low health, Mikasa.
I guess he leaped in for a kill, or maybe he leaped away. Maybe, whatever the case is.
Maybe underestimated the 3 points in overload.
Yeah. Also, CTY going for a more or less an unorthodox build. He has that single point into Electric Vortex. Normally, you don't, you know, pick it simply because it delays your other levels and farm. CTY jumping a little bit away.
No, he's getting himself low. He's got only got one Tango, so just need to be a bit careful. Arias to secure the siege creep, but yeah, Mikasa shaking up a little bit there in the mid lane, and the CS as well. It's just gone from strength to strength for CTY. This is a great opening for him in the mid. 31-11 against 18-1, and the fact that CTY picks up that first blood, this is an ideal start for a Storm, for
yes.
Sure, no doubt about that.
No, you and I are still doubting the Storm pick somewhat, and most of the time that we do see CTY ramping completely out of control, and we'll kind of have a keep a closer eye onto his Bloodstone timing and whatnot.
Ends as well. 2k gold saved up. Does he just go for a straight out blink, or do you still have to get the phase and such before that? Or if you have the gold, do you just go all in and pick that purchase up?
Well, I think if he won a phase, he would have gotten it by now. So it makes sense. You want to go blink. He is picked mostly to actually kill the Drow Ranger. You know, this early in the game, he pretty much could kill everybody on Vici apart from the Storm. And you would like to start a kill right now by going to the secret shop, pick up a blink, and just go on the Witch Doctor.
FY's managed to pick himself up a few levels as well, rotating around the lane. He's now level 3 on the Elder Titan. Still top, you know, Burning's Visage. He's been clearing out this camp, trying to find what he can. He's reaching halfway through level 4.
Oh, I like the Ursa rotation. He went to the side shop, bought a TP, salved up, and I think they're going to smoke up here as well. And that Drow... Well, she's going to die unless she gets herself out of there right now.
There we go. And he's going to be ready to run and ready to dive with the blink and the ultimate. Here we go. Surge forward, straight in. 1, 2, 3. Give it a fourth,
Gus?
And you'll be able to find yourself the kill. End picks up the Drow Ranger. There'll be a reaction from Vici just through burning, but TP's cancelled from the rest of the side.
Oh, they're going
to
die.
Burning's going to be careful. Yeah, he's going to try for the TP out. Can he get himself away yet? No vacuum at the moment, skilled by Yang. So the Visage is okay. But nonetheless, as you said, yeah, great rotations from VG. I feel like we see a lot of Chinese teams do this with the cores. As soon as they are like that level 6, immediately looking for some action across the map. They very rarely and very seldom just stay in the lane after hitting 6. They're ready to use their hero to the best potential.
Yeah, you see that a lot mostly with heroes like Terrorblade.
Yeah.
You gank with that Metamorphosis and then you push a tower off of it. But a little bit different here with the Ursa. But I think the job is accomplished, right? You make sure you shut down the Drow, and so far they are doing just that. So this Ursa pick, at least for now, has been working extremely well. I don't think the Drow Ranger has really done too much. It helped the mid lane win very, very hard. But apart from that, I think VGR is really happy with the positioning in this game.
Well, Burning came around, dropped down a deep ward just towards the mid lane. And CTY is a reaction bottom. RTK is there as well, and he does have the Ravage. They really want to try and set something up. Only FY on his Elder Titan down here at the moment. Same time towards the mid lane. HYM's been looking for the farm. DDC in position, so is End on the sidelines. HYM's got to be careful in case they do look to jump in with this Ursa. And he will be.
If you go to Dire Vision right now, you're very, very scared because you just don't see Ursa on the map. So for example, that bottom dive that they're thinking of making, they could jump in and perhaps get a kill, but if they lose the Storm as a result, that is no good. End now shows himself on the mid lane. So VG, at least momentarily, will feel empowered to make something happen.
They're going to set up something with the third Moonlight Shadow. Moving immediately into position. FY just getting himself out. Mid lane, it's just to kind of look for the bait and signing the shadows. And yeah, at the least, this gets FY out safely and allows VG to keep their position in the mid lane. Where VG Gaming, they've kind of been all over the place. They headed down bottom, looked for some kind of action, just didn't find it, and CTY is now trying to return. He needs to be careful a little bit.
Oh,
there's
Ursa.
A lot of them around. Yeah, not the control to deal with the Storm Spirit. CTY zips out. Vici Gaming is putting on the pressure down bottom. Burning. Closing in on his level 6. And top. Silent just facing up with Yang. If you have a look at the net worth at the moment, as we can see, things have been going well for VGR in the laning stage. I mean, they've not been going bad for VG Gaming, but as you said, with the draft that VG has, that things need to be going a little bit better, you feel?
Yeah, they definitely do. And it's so disruptive for VG to actually lose these outer towers, because they're going to open the Roshan to the Ursa as well. So VG, they have a lot of things they have to keep track of. Ursa on the bottom lane here, looking on Burning, but the quick wave chill. Looks like they might actually even turn around here against End. Arrow not going to actually kill up on anybody. End's trying to run away. The Ravage will
they're
come.
Kill him. They have got backup feature game and Repumper, and is the damage reduction going to be enough? CTY is coming in. He's looking for this Ursa kill in the tree line, and he will find it. They'll take down N, bringing in Mikasa with the Vortex as well. He's already used his leap. There'll be a Cold Embrace trying to buy time for the Mirana, but surely he's still going to go down. The cast bounce has come out, and Vici Gaming find themselves a second on top of the tower. So there we have it. Maybe End just going a little bit too gun-ho on the Ursa as VG Reborn are quick to react with a Ravage.
Yeah, he really relied on his ultimate to keep himself alive, but Enrage doesn't really last that long, and VG has a lot of way to keep up with you with Grave Chill, with the Storm Spirit, with the Gush and whatnot. And yeah, great pick here by VG Gaming. They have slowed down the Ursa, and all the meantime, Drought Ranger was just free farming, so they definitely needed that recovery. Drought Ranger, I imagine his first item of choice would be something like a Dragon Lance. Just give him the stats and whatnot, but he's saving up a ton of gold. Is this going to be something like a Blink Dagger first for the Drought Ranger?
Yeah, this certainly is interesting to see. Yeah, I saw that.
Because normally, if you go Dragon Lance, you'll buy the two, you know, the Bands of Elven Skin right now to give your team more agility or more damage. So, given the fact that he's been saving for this long, I think he just wants to blink away from the Ursa when he sees the big bad bear coming.
That certainly could be the case. As it's just, yeah, just over 100 gold away from it. Meanwhile, over on the side of VGR, Yang now has the mechanism completed. So a little bit ready to take on these fights when VG Gaming do go for pushes. VGR, however, grouping up towards the mid. Mikasa's got the Moonlight Shadow if they want to use it. They're gonna choose to use the smoke first.
VGR right now, they want to look for a pick into Roshan.
Yeah.
That's their goal.
I mean, could they just go straight into Roshan? Do they need to find a kill?
No, apparently not. They're going to go straight into it. You know what? Ravage is down for about 30 more seconds, so they feel empowered to do so. The scan comes out, but it doesn't scan into Roshan, so...
Oh, DDC comes out, though. Don't do it, DDC.
Ooh, oh, okay, he's in there
fine,
still.
They're fine, yeah. No one put their heads out of the pit,
the
so
birds
the
are coming.
Scan. All right, yeah. The jig is up. Now the question is, what can VG Gaming do to respond to this one? Ooh. Still not, you know, no Ravage for 15 seconds. The birds trying to disrupt VG Gaming Reborn's attempt.
I don't know what's happening.
Oh, come on, China lag. Not like this. Okay, we're good, we're good. Nothing's happening yet. Here we have. Here's the start of the fight. Yang coming forward, vacuum onto two.
They got Ravage now.
They're still trying to create space for N to finish off the Roshi's back in, but the birds are going to be incredibly disruptive. Palace goes well. In fact, they're going on to end the death board as well. And he's down. They've lost the Ursa, and Mikasa silenced up, nuked down as well. They've found two. The Ravage comes out. It does nothing, but it doesn't matter because VG Gaming are already cleaning up this fight. CTY moving in with a double damage, takes down another. There'll be a buyback from the Mirana. Three did end up going down on the side of VG Gaming due to a very nice Earth split up from VGR.
I don't know what that Ravage is about, but...
That was not the Ravage.
Mikasa runs right in. He's got the two birds helping him out.
That's
a dieback.
Mikasa! What was that? He bought back, walks into the pit. CTY just is like, hello, on the double damage Storm Spirit. And there's birds as well. I think he just had a brain fart, Mikasa.
All right, I'm not going to say that was a great play, but from his perspective, they just brought Roshan really, really low, and he was afraid that Vici's going to get it. So they're like, okay, well, we need a buyback and prevent this from happening. Vici's like, okay, thanks for the free kill. We'll take those.
That was not the play there for the Mirana. That's really going to set him back in the net worth. I mean, look at this Mirana. It was doing all right at the start, but now straight down the board in net worth.
Mm-hmm.
And Gus knocked himself back.
Remember what I said about Mirana in the drafting phase?
Oh,
he will bring nothing to you until get that axe and... Well, the Roshan he was worried about, it's happening right now, and there is no buyback for him to back them up.
Oh, hello. Goodbye. And licking himself away. They still feel scared about going in to finish off this Rosh. And VGR, they are ready to give it another attempt. Heading back over into the pit, but the birds, I mean, the burning birds that have kind of been keeping
so
watch.
Annoying.
They're so annoying. Yeah.
Yeah.
They've been doing so much to disrupt this Rosh attempt.
All right,
the Visage Birds.
For the item checkup here, we got the Sylar picking up. Went back for a Dragon Lance. So.
Oh, I did go for the Dragon Lance. Okay.
And looks like we do have the mechanism being picked up right now for RLTK as well. I think the Dire team is thinking about smoking around here. Speaking of smoke, VGR pops their own smoke. They need to open this fight with an immediate kill.
Yeah, and needs to jump and just take someone out of the fight. And here we have, he might find it. Jumps in onto Burning the Arrow as well. Yeah, Burning. Oh, the mech, keeping it alive for time being. Doesn't matter. Carson, Death Ward, immediately counteracted by the Cold Embrace onto end. He's going to be fine. Sala hitting the three-man silence. They'll look to Mikasa. The control burns, but Mikasa leaps away. CTY brings in Yang. Yang on the dark side. Vacuum Winter's Curse. Yang still alive. The Earthspin and follow-up end. Jumping in. Looking to take them down. Oh, TK incredibly low, but he's going to live. No! Burst out by the Starfall by Mikasa, but it doesn't matter. VGR, they've still lost two. Xylo hits the silence onto ENZ. HYM moving in as well. They need to kill off this Ursa.
The CTY, birds.
He's got to get out of the fight, but indeed the burning birds, the visage birds return. They're going to have the drop again in a few seconds. The paralyzing Cosminista will allow the birds to close in. Get the first turn off. Get the second one off. The micro from burning. It's beautiful. They're fighting kill. Mikasa jumping in with the Starfall, trying to turn it. HYM out of mana. Now he's out of health. They've lost Witch Doctor as well. And this time, Mikasa will be the reigning victor of this fight. But again, it's a bloody battle for both sides as they lose multiple heroes. I've got to say, though, throughout this all, Burning Visage is looking pretty good. The Burn Micro is real.
Well, to be fair, he did die that fight, so all he had to do was Micro the Burst.
He was just looking at the Burst.
Yeah, yeah, so let's not give him too much credit.
He can cope with two units, not three.
Yeah. But Vici Gaming, that was a 3-for-3 trade, and I think these kind of trade does favor Vici and not VGR, because you can see how desperate VGR is playing. They're just diving behind the Tier 1. And they initiated that fight with an immediate kill on Burning.
Yeah.
And they hit the big Echo Stomp plus Winter's Curse. And they traded evenly. So I cannot imagine if VGR get the jump that they want, Vici is going to win those fights. I do have to apologize because right now both of these teams are Vici and VGR.
It's very confusing.
Maybe it's easier if we go Vici and Reborn.
And Reborn. We'll stick with just Reborn for the Radiant. Yeah.
Yeah. So
it's a bit of a mouthful.
Yeah. If Vici gets the jump that they want, Reborn is in big trouble.
Roshan still stands. I mean, I think Roshan's the real winner here.
Oh, sure. He's just taunting everybody. He's like, come get me, guys.
Looks like at this point as well, both teams realizing, all right, let's settle down. Let's just try and keep some farm up on the cores. They've returned back to lanes. But as well, one thing, you know, CTY Storm Spirit, he's been playing these fights absolutely perfectly. He's 5-0-4 on the Storm. He's going to have a good timing on the Bloodstone. And he's, you know, well ahead at the top. And he's just, double damages are coming out his backside. He's just picked up another one.
Yeah, this is a good draft for Storm. I mean, if you look at the Reborn lineup, what exactly is he really locking him down?
Absolutely.
You know, a curse into an arrow,
really,
I guess, a clap.
There's nothing too reliable.
Yeah, all of these things he could kind of jump and dance around, so.
It's the Winter's Curse, as you said. That's what you got to look to set up into a follow-through stun.
The only time that he should be really dying this game is if CTY pulls a CTY and goes ham.
Yeah.
Hopefully he will have that self-control and he'll be okay. We're kind of in a low here. And I think every time the game is slowing down, it should, at least for the next 10 minutes, favor the Drow Ranger. Because you do have to keep in mind that Ursa is just not a quick farmer. And Mirana with a dieback is not a quick farmer.
No, he's starting to climb his way back up the ranks, Mikasa, but he certainly did put himself down quite a bit. Yeah, about halfway through the Aghanims at the moment. So maybe still on track for kind of around that 20-ish minute or so build, as you said, which is, you know, not the end of the world for VGR. They're still holding in, and look at the lead. It's, you know, VG Gaming only by 1K. And as we said in the draft, you know, with the kind of lineup that VG Gaming have picked up this match, you probably were hoping for a bit more of a convincing lead at this stage of the game. But I think you'll still be very happy with the fact that CTY is having a great game. You know, 17 minutes in, 5-0-4, and he's now got the Bloodstone done.
Yep. Well, they are going to look for a bigger lead here as they smoke up S4. ROTK does not have to blink yet, but let's see if he can basically walk in and get a good Ravage off. Stormster also part of that gang party. They see Mikasa. I think if they could choose one person to kill, it's got to be the Mirana.
If you can slow down this man's axe, this is just a huge weight off your shoulders.
Well, they did see Ursa just walk by that Observer. Ooh, this is going to be close.
Mikasa. Oh, hello. Oh, DDC. Yeah, he's going to be on to pay for his crimes. He tries to come across. Ooh! Yeah, not going to save you from the Soul Assumption Nuke. Very nicely done there by VG. They do find the pickoff and immediately pings onto the Roshan pit. So one hero down. VG Gaming. See if they do try for Rosh. Looks like they're going to give it their best shot, but I'm sure VG are there. You know, 20 seconds Wyvern's back up. They're probably, there's going to be time for them to get over it.
Yes, and it's so hard to do Rosh against Elder Titan. because he drops a spirit and you kind of just have to run. And here comes the spirit.
Actually, this is incredibly quick. Yeah, he's got to stomp straight away.
Stomp. Oh, it's going to stomp pretty late.
They're giving up on it. They're saying, all right, it's too quick. Yeah, the Drow Aura doing wonders for Vici Gaming. And Reborn, yeah, they've just got to let that one go. So they get the Aegis that they're after. And obviously, yeah, CTY as well, especially with the Bloodstone. This is arguably one of the best Aegis carriers of the game at this stage. You know, 19 minutes in a Bloodstone Storm. This is brilliant for CTY.
Interesting to see Burning skipping the Medallion altogether.
They went straight Axe.
Straight Axe. Synergize so well with their damage output, but I guess what they're looking at is more kind of a macro level game. The birds are proving to be extremely annoying, so why not get one more, I suppose.
Top lane, Mikasa. Now just 1k short of his Aghanims. And for Sylar, Shadowblade will be the pickup. So it's obviously going to force VGR supports to invest in that detection and limit the chances of End being able to just jump in and solo the Drow Ranger unless he's got some kind of detection backup.
You know, Owen, normally, if you tell me that, hey, VG's got a Drow Draft and they only push one tower in 20 minutes, and having watching this game, I'll be like, oh man, Owen, they lost that game, for sure.
So what's keeping them in it in your mind?
You know, they're just out farming and out fighting. Mikasa's buyback at the Roshan fights just didn't really help. They got the Aegis. So they're basically playing a farming game with the Drow Ranger, and they're just out farming the enemy team. It's very helpful that, you know, the enemy team carries that Ursa, which doesn't really scale well without kills. I mean, Ursa just, it's a big melee creep if you think about it, if he's not getting a billion kills. And right now he's got two.
Oh, mid lane, look, Mikasa, the man at the moment that we're talking about, he's dead again. Did manage to spend his gold though. You know, picks up the two components at the same time.
Storm, making jumps.
Moving in for more. FY, he's going to be the one to cut caught out. And there we have it. Another Bloodstone charge for CTY. Vici Gaming, you know, they find themselves two kills. They're ready to push.
Yeah, this is the push, right? Like, it's definitely going to get a tier one. It's most likely going to get a tier two as well. Winter Wyvern coming into, trying to do what he can with the Splinter Blast, which is maxed out by now. But I don't think Vici actually cares.
Yeah, and with the Blink Dagger now up on ROTK. They have got everything ready for the fight. Ravage is up. Death Ward's there as well. It's a very hard fight for VGR to come into, so they're doing exactly what they need to. You know, they're ignoring it for the time being. Ends pushing up top. Yang's split pushing bottom. But as you said, VG Gaming, they'll find themselves a tier two. And this is, you know, the draft working perfectly. Top lane, CTY looking to set up onto End. They've got a Moonlight Shadow. Does CTY have the detection? He doesn't, unfortunately. And nonetheless, already using the Vortex. Wouldn't have been able to hold back that Ursa from TPing away. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, we're seeing if Reborn can find something on the back of it. Arrow's going to be juked out by HYM. Mikasa's going to continue with the chase. The Stomp will connect. Can they save this man? Yeah. Silence of the Mikasa.
No.
Again, he's just stepped too far. The Grease, the Conic Brace will come in by RTK with a four-man Ravage. Death Ward's laid down, punching his Yang, but he vacuum cancels the Death Ward, starts to surge away.
Curse.
But CTY flies through, takes down Mikasa. They'll look to DDC in the sidelines as well. The mech's being popped. It's not going to be enough to keep him alive as the birds. ROTK chases him down. They find themselves another. They did manage to pop the Storm Spray, but CTY, he's more than fine with that. Gives him a new full mana bar. FY managing to deny himself to the neutral creeps. But nonetheless, again, Vici Gaming coming on top of these fights, and CTY getting richer and richer as he starts to build towards the Orchid.
Mikasa seems to be on a very different page from the rest of VGR. He's generally like more ahead than the rest of his team. We're going to see a Winter Wyvern buyback back wall.
That's
all
a
right.
Big one as well. End jumps here looking for some kind of cleanup potential, but the follow-up's just not good enough. It was a flashy wall, but not a wall that's going to cause too many issues for Vici Gaming. At the least, Reborn are able to stop the push.
Yeah. They were essentially stopping the bleeding because the wound is still very gaping. It's still there. If you look over to CTY, we're going to see him getting the Orchid relatively soon. Drow Ranger, apart from the first death, remember the smoke that they went up with the Ursa to get a gank on him, has not died since. Has picked up the Shadow Blade, which is going to give Ursa more and more trouble as the game goes on. And speaking of that Ursa, he's running away from 1v1 fights now. Ursa should never be in a situation where he has to run away from a 1v1 fight. I do believe VGR had this kind of counter to the Drow lineup, and this draft has really failed him.
And then we have it as well. Another unfortunate action there for VGR coming around with a smoke. Immediately dispelled by CTY and he just sips himself out. So unable to find anything there with that rotation. Xylas, he's picking up the gold as well. 2.5k on top of his Shadow Blade as he sits there just beneath C2Y on the board. And Burning, now 23 minutes in, has got the Aghanims done on Visage.
So I think we're looking into a territory of thinking how VCR could maybe make a comeback and win this game. And honestly, I think the game is beyond their control. Like, they need Vici to actually help them by making a couple of mistakes. Whether that's CTY jumping in over-aggressive into the hands of Reborn, whether it's ROTK whiffing a Ravage, whether Sylar goes out farming by himself and gets picked by a Smoke Gank, they need something pretty drastic. Drastic mistake from Vici to come make a comeback. In a straight-up fight, I don't see Vici losing the Reborn here.
CTY, as we're saying, yeah, very close to having the Orchid done. And then I guess once he's picked that up, who is he looking to zip onto in these team fights to control first? Is it one of these backline supports? Are you looking for DDC to make sure the save isn't there for the side?
Yeah, DDC is target number one in a gank. An actual team fight may be the Darkseer, simply because he has so much counterplay potential.
But he does have the Greaves, though.
He does.
Yeah.
But if you just force him to use a Greave, like right in the beginning of the fight, I think you're okay with that for an Orchid, because you could just jump back out. Also, Elder Titan is a pretty good target to go on. There's not going to be a shortage of target here for CTY.
No. That was a lot of good people to go on. So about Greaves, our TK has now picked up his own over on the Tidehunter, so he's looking in very good fighting shape. I mean, Burning, with the Aghanims done on the Visage, is there? Does he go back for the Medallion? Is there any reason not to, or does he start picking up auras? What's the build now for the Visage?
I still think that the Solar Crest is quite good against the Ursa. But maybe building for against Ursa is not even the priority anymore, because I think the most dangerous hero right now for VGR is actually Mirana. So maybe you build to counter her, whether it's picking up a Glimmer Cape to protect your team, maybe a Hood into a Pipe so you could push better. I think there's definitely a lot of possibility here for Vici. They're getting into luxury territory. They already have everything that they need to win the game.
C2Y can find a nice pickup with this as well. He's just, you know, backseated himself an Invis rune. Ah, okay, so he's not going to look for anything with it. Dispels it immediately. But he does have that Orchid done now. So VGR have got to be very careful with their positioning. As you can see at the moment, they are just keeping themselves together as five, making sure that the pickup potential isn't there for the side of Vici Gaming. Mm-hmm. Sylar with the BKB done as well, so he himself is in a lot better fighting shape. I mean, this has got to be good news just as a whole looking at Sylar. The fact that you're running a Drow lineup against this draft of VGR, and he's only died the once this game.
Correct. And he's probably not going to die much more, simply because he has Shadowblade and BKB. Well, we're going to see a four-man Smoke Gank showing the Storm on the bottom here. I think Reborn understands that there's good reasons for them to not leave the base. I say that though. Sylar finds Yang.
Yep. Opens with a silence. RTK jumping in as well. Greed to remove it. Ravage comes through onto three. There's not going to be any follow up for the time because End. He just turns and fights. Takes down HYM out of this one. Now he's going to move in for more. Let's watch on the back line. Storm zipping in. Playing around us, but the Storm connects onto two. Has to zip himself out of this one. End moving towards CTI. Still juking it out. Playing around the team. They will finish off DDC. Can they actually get themselves anything else here? ROTK being focused. CTY tries to come in for the save. The silence onto End, but there's the follow through. Arrow Storm onto CTY. Can they kill this man?
I don't know.
The Chinese lag. It's too much, but CTY. He's gone down. He will manage to get off the Bloodstone Deny. You know, they found two from VGR, but this time Vici Gaming having the more, you know, more casualties, three dead. So a good hop from Vici Gaming and CTY going down, never really the dream, but at the least he does deny, of course, that goal going away from his kill streak because of the Bloodstone.
That was such a 3-2-2.
Yeah.
You're so far ahead. All you need to do is group up and push. They took a team fight in a very awkward spot. It's a 2-3 in favor of VGR, and Vici gave away the gem. They bought the gem to make that play. We do see a huge jump coming in here against N, and will go down as a result here.
CTY just absolutely no chilling. He's on point every time with these hips.
But in the matter of about 1 minute, I think Vici lost about net worth wise.
Yeah.
I mean, the gold graph doesn't really do justice in terms of how big of a lead they gave away. Because right now, Vici is playing a very momentum draft and just gave away a whole bunch of kills and the gem. So I think Reborn's right back in this game, despite the fact that they're not really farming that well. They're not really fighting that well.
Vici Gaming are going to get the Aegis again by the looks of those. So this is good. This kind of restabilizes it for them. They may have lost that fight, you know, by an extra kill. But now they've got the Aegis back on CT. Well, CT2 has not picked up yet. He's I'm sure we'll be back in for that. Yeah, but he's like, come on, mate. There we go.
Do you remember that game in Nanyang?
Yep, where they didn't pick up the cheese.
No, he didn't pick up the Aegis.
Oh, was it the Aegis?
He was playing Ursa.
Was
he
it CTY again?
CTY.
Oh, man, it's the same man, yeah.
He went to the Roshan pit, killed it as Ursa, and just walked off. And I remember like the caster was just like, oh, he's saving it for a time. You
and
know?
then he was like, okay, this has gone on for quite a long time now.
And the post-game interview, we asked him, he's like, oh, I just forgot.
They did go on to win that game, didn't they?
Yeah, they did.
Yeah, yeah.
Imagine if they lost it. We would just be like, oh, CTY. Looks like he's going to go for a...
Linkards?
Okay.
Do you think?
What is he blocking?
Actually, well, Winter's Curse, as we talked about, the one big lockdown. You know what I mean? If he gets himself a Lincoln, suddenly...
That's literally the only thing that's blocking it, though. Because you don't block arrow with it either.
No. Yeah, it'd just be the Winter's Curse. I mean, I guess it has to be. There's...
What else is it blocking?
It's not Refresh your Storm. Battle Fury Storm? Nope. Lotus Orb Storm? Unlikely, yeah. It's got to be Lincoln's, yeah. But no, it's... I mean, this game, I guess if you're going for a defensive item... You know, if you look at what BKB, Lincolns, Yules, you know, there's not really any silences. You don't really need a BKB. You're going to go for the Lincolns.
I mean, Hex is always a strong alternative, right? If you want to be more offensive.
I guess you want to be aggressive, yeah. That's true. But I guess at the same time he feels at this moment with the Orchid, well, he was able to kill the Ursa. I mean, now the BKB's coming out, it's going to get harder for him to get away with those plays.
For sure, yeah.
We'll see. Oh, jump in. Hello. Go. Goodbye. HYM. Chopped down in a few... A few swipes from end. Psylar, he's trying to go for this, and CTY falling through as well. Oh, and kept alive by the Cold Embrace. He's going to live through this initial initiation.
Curse.
Now the Winter's Curse in return, trying to jump in. Psylar shooting away as his own teammate, the burst, but it's enough for CTY to get himself out. He is out of mana, though, so they can't fight back into this one with the Storm Spirit. Mikasa jumps in at the same time. DDC being focused by Burning's Birds, Burning and RTK starting to back up. Spitter comes through, doesn't quite reach RTK and CTY. Oh, hang on. He's ready to go back in.
Oh, he's out of the mana.
Well, with the birds, they found it. They lose RTK. CTY trying to play around Yang, but again, the stomp's there. The arrow from Mikasa following through. Have they got the damage to bring down CTY? Doesn't look like it. And in fact, CTY and the Burning Birds are just chasing Vici Gaming Reborn out of this whole engagement. Psylar trying to close the gap with the Shadow Blade. They're moving behind the tier ones. It looks like that will be settling down now for VGR.
Well, end of the day, it's a 1-for-1 trade, but again, Vici is so much more ahead. Oh, arrow!
Oh, CT.
He's got no respect. He's like, I'll play this, no problem. Every time I watch CTY play, I'm on the edge of my seat. For the wrong reasons, really. But,
he's a bit of a madman.
Yeah.
But yeah, he's racking up the gold. He can pick up that ultimate all for that Lincolns. And I was Burning God coming out. Yeah, he did go for the medallion. Picks up a Ghost Scepter as well. So very nice against this Ursa, who does have a bit of money. Could go for the Diffusal Blade next if End wants to. Do you think that is going to be the case with Ghost Scepters potentially coming out for VG? Or does he just look elsewhere for more lockdowns as he himself just try and work for the Abyssal Blade to look for another source to take down CTY?
You know, Ghost Scepter is a great idea. You mentioned the Visage getting Ghost Scepter. You could break that Lincolns, I guess, on the Storm if you want. But maybe a straight up basher is not too bad either.
Okay.
Because CT-wise, I mean, there's nothing that could actually help him if he gets straight up bashed. It just is more about whether he's thinking about building offensive or defensive. He could pick up a defensive item like a Vlad for the team as well if he wants. I personally like the basher, but he does have that Morbid Mask just kind of hanging out.
Linker's for you. And he now does the CT-Y. Overall net worth difference, still favouring the side of Vici Gaming. And they have taken tier 1s, tier 2s in every lane apart from the top. And CTY, Zip Zap Zoo comes in onto end, but the Cold Embrace reaction will be there.
Oh, curse.
Oh. All right. A little bit unfortunate there for the side. They're still going to chase down. He's got a bit of mana to work with here, and he does have the Burning Birds to come down with the stomps if he needs something else to back him up. So, a little bit of unfortunate use of the Winter's Curse. I just didn't do an item check. He's only just picked up the Lincolns. Didn't know that CTY has it. They know now, for sure, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think in that engagement, we've seen why he needed to pick up the Lincolns. Even though it only blocks the one spell. The one spell guarantees his death, right? Because we do see the curse, and then it leads into an easy arrow. And there's no way he survives throughout, you know, the sun duration of the arrow. Yeah. So Ursa does go back to pick up that Diffusal Blade. Now they have an answer to that Lincoln pretty easily.
And I guess one thing that's nice as well, even though you aren't able to do damage yourself to the target, I guess you can still start to stack up the Fury Swipes, you know what I mean? So when he then comes out, you're going to already have some extra bonus damage to smack him with.
For sure.
Yeah.
The other nice thing that N could do is to get rid of the Orchid debuff.
Yeah.
On his allies or on himself.
Yeah, that's true. On the Diffusal.
Well, you know, the momentum that Vichy really had and the lead that they had is really kind of going away. Interesting choice here by Mirana. I think he's looking to basically Yules into an arrow hit against the Storm.
Okay.
I would personally favor something like a Scythe of Ice purchase. Because you already have the Blink already built in. And if you're looking for a disable, a Blink Hex is probably as good as it gets, really, in the game of Dota.
I mean, I guess it is good against the Storm's Orchid, you know, to save yourself.
Correct. I guess I'm thinking just straight up offense.
Yeah, for the offense, yeah.
And he's building kind of half offense, half
offense.
Why did he Yules, Mikasa?
Did you not have vision?
Oh. The
spirit came out, yeah. Maybe, yeah, just a little bit of the reaction. I mean, even so, the arrow very, very close to hitting.
Okay, Drow Ranger picks up a butterfly, so everybody's attacking really hard.
Yeah, 76 bonus damage across the board. At this point, Agi, you know, for the whole five man, there's so much more damage. And Yang indeed picked off immediately. End will jump in with the BKB. Trying to fight. Actually, just jumps in. BKB's TP is out. No. Oh, he's not going to make it.
Not against the Drow.
They
dropped the gem as well. So whatever the lead that they had about 5 minutes ago, it's all gone. RTK just is looking for a straggler. They won't find any. And here comes the Vichy push.
Yeah, I think that butterfly pickup pretty much secured that kill. The extra bonus damage for everyone. I mean, yeah, this aura, as I was saying, doing the maths, it's like, extra 380 damage overall for the whole side. They've just gone plus up 380.
Yeah. Don't forget the birds, too, when they pop.
Oh, and the birds, yeah, when they pop the active of Drow, yeah.
I think this...
The push is so strong.
That tower is dead. Good luck, tower. Okay, arrow will hit. They're going to try to burst down RTK, but good luck with that. Glimmer Cape helping him out, but look at his tower. Oh, Glyph is going to come out.
And this is all right. Sylar still held on to the active. He knew that they were going to fortify. Now he'll pop the active post-fortification. And look at this. The push. The Drow Visage returns.
Well, we're not seeing... Well, we're seeing half of it, but...
Hey, you're all right as well. Your prediction should have gone with you. Vichy Gaming to be the ones to take the first Raxan. Oh, not the Winter's Curse you're looking for, really.
Nope.
Though.
No. Are they air on top? Are they going to stomp on top as well?
I mean, they're trying to kill him. It's not going to work as CTY jumps in, grabs Mikasa. Mikasa gets nuked down immediately and as well trying to move. But look at the physical damage coming through. The Ravage from RTK. They're all dying. 3 dead at the moment on VGR. Yak pops the BKB, but it's not going to save you against this Drow lineup.
GG.
And what a performance from VG Gaming, making the Drow Visage combination work. CTY Storm. It looked a bit shoddy yesterday. Today it was absolutely amazing. What a lineup! What a draft from VG Gaming, and something, you know, we've seen so many games of this qualifiers, but still this late on, we're still seeing something a bit different.
Yeah, the most impressive thing was just the Drow first pick, and they still executed the strategy that the way they wanted to execute it. With that said, though, Reborn did really mess up a lot. Mikasa has not been the star player for me this game.
Which is because Mikasa across the whole qualifier so far, he's been really reliable, but this game. It just didn't work out for him.
Yeah, I think Reborn, looking back in the game, maybe they say to themselves, look, we had the right draft to deal with what's coming our way. Our execution was just a little bit off. So I think coming into the game, too, I don't think they're too shaken up by this. I think they're fine, and they could kind of adjust and move forward from there.
Oh, there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Don't go anywhere. So we will be back for Game 2 to see if VGR can bring it back or if VG Gaming, again, can bring out one of these this crazy kind of strats. With the Drow Visage, get new heroes left, right, and center to bring themselves to a 2-0 and cement their place in the finals of the region against eHome. Don't go anywhere, ladies and gentlemen.